Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. We were on a live stream and someone was like, hey, can you create field parameters against a semantic model that's been created against a lake house or a warehouse, one that's in direct lake mode? I was like, I don't know. I think you can. I don't know if you can, but of course we're gonna try. Before we get into it, just a caution. This is like some pinky in the brain experiment type of I didn't mean to say. If you don't know Pinky and the Brain is, you probably should go search. It's a great cartoon. And I'm experimenting and I'm gonna see if I can get this to work, okay? So enough of all this talking. You know what we like to do? Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So I have a lake house that I've created. If you wanted to follow along, create a lake house in your Fabric workspace and choose a new semantic model, and you can build out a model. You can choose the tables you want directly in the web browser. You can create your semantic model. I've created two. This particular semantic model, I have not touched it with the XMLA endpoint. So we go here, open model, and I can creating measures, calculation groups. These two are disabled. I don't know if they're coming. Manage roles, I'm pretty sure it's on the roadmap already. You can do relationships, you can create a report. You can add and remove tables from your model. So if somebody added new tables to the lake house and you wanted to add them to the model, you could definitely do that. Here's your model view where you can create calculation groups and measures and different things directly in a web browser. Now, if we go over to my model right here and I choose open data model view, it's gonna say you can't do that because it's been modified by the XMLA endpoint. If I get that endpoint and go to, let's say, tablet editor, because that's what I'm going to use. Big shout out to Daniel and all the team over there. Thanks for creating a great tool. If I connect with the XMLA endpoint using tablet editor and I add a measure, I do anything to this model, I can no longer open and edit this model using the model view in the web browser. I'm gonna have to rely on tablet editor for maintaining that model. And it's okay, because it does a great job. And it's offering me the ability to test out to see if I can create field parameters. Now, I don't know if they're supported. Let's do an experiment. So we're gonna go back to our workspace and we're gonna go to workspace settings, premium, scroll to the bottom, grab your XMLA endpoint. And then once you get your XMLA endpoint, you'll click right here, put it in, click connect, and you'll be connected to your model. So here's my model. If you want to create a field parameter is a sort of a table. So what I would do is right click here, choose create new table, and then put my field parameter script in. It would look something like this. So I opened up Power BI Desktop just so you could see I created a parameter here in Power BI Desktop. And this is what the script would be. You would honestly create a table, copy something like this, and then add it. So go here, create new table, and then paste the script right there. Then what I found is there's some properties that you need to set on the column. On the tables. It's a lot of work to get it done. But fortunately, Daniel provided us with a beautiful C# script that we can use to get this working. So let me show you. Let's go ahead and delete this. And then I found this link, this discussion, where people are requesting the ability to create field parameters directly in Tableau Editor. Daniel's like, wow, I agree. It should be a built-in feature. Here's a short-term solution. It's a nice little script. So instead of right-clicking, creating a table, and then setting the properties, there's so many properties you gotta set. Daniel provided us with a quick workaround. And I'm gonna show you how to use that to get the field parameter working. So I'm gonna copy this script. And then what I'm gonna do is, you see, in Tableau Editor, there's a new C# script shortcut. So I'm gonna go ahead and click that. I'm gonna paste this script in. And then you gotta read these notes at the top. He's saying, before you run this script, do these things. So I'm gonna change this to EO Daniel Atakia Field Param. That's what we're gonna call this. And then he says, okay, now what I need you to do is hold down the measures in the fields that you wanna be part of the field parameter. So what I'm gonna do is, I wanna include borough. I'm gonna hold down control. I'm gonna choose service zone, and I'm gonna choose payment type. I want those three columns to be part of the field parameter. And then what's great is Daniel takes care of everything for you, even setting the properties. You can see I'm hiding this, setting the group by, setting the extended property. He's taking care of all that for me. So I'm gonna go ahead and click run. It ran. I'm gonna save this out to my model. And then what I'm gonna do is, here's my model. I'm gonna go create report. There's the DOF parameter. Let's click it, see if this works. I got an error. And it says the query reference calculated needs to be refreshed, okay? It's gotta pull some data. And I was curious about this. I'm like, oh boy, I don't know what this means, but let's go see if I can recalculate this table. So I'm gonna click close, go back over to Tableau Editor, and Tableau Editor offers all these capabilities. I'm just gonna right click on it and say, calculate the table. It's done. And then what I'm gonna do is delete this. I'm gonna refresh here one more time. I'm gonna add a slicer to the page, and then I'm gonna add this. boom, there's my field parameter. There is a little question mark here. Now, you need to test this out and make sure this works with your model. I'm gonna add this, then I'm gonna add my field parameter here. And so you can see everything's there. And then I'm gonna choose burrow. It's only showing the burrows. I'm gonna choose service zones. It's only showing the service zones. And I choose pavement type. It only shows the pavement types. This works. I gotta go dig into this and see what are the true implications of, you know, doing this via the tablet editor. I did get it to work. I'm excited. Thank you, Daniel, for providing the script. You still can get this working. If you don't want to use the script, you can go step by step. If you just want to kind of know what properties are being set to get an extended parameter to work with tablet editor. But so far, so good. I'll continue to test. You continue to test. If you got any questions, comments, help someone out, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about field parameters, there's probably a video flying above my head that I did on field parameters on our YouTube. Go check it out. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.